You could win $32,000 on the turn of a card on Card Sharks. And if you play your cards right, you can win this beautiful Jeep Wrangler. And now the host of Card Sharks, Bill Rafferty.
Hello. Hello, Bob. Welcome, everybody at home. Welcome to another edition of Card Sharks. Exciting show today, I'm sure. We've got a new champion to meet. We've got lots of prizes to give away. Yesterday, we did give away that brand new Jeep Wrangler, but there's no reason to say we're not going to give another one away today. Let's get started right now by meeting our lovely dealers. Here they come, Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams. We finally gave that car away.
Oh, how exciting.
We had a bit of a car drought here, but yesterday we knocked it off. Yes. That's your favorite, too, isn't it?
I love that Jeep. I love it.
I always feel like Matt Houston when I'm around that car, you know? Anyway, let's get started right from the top. Deal out the cards, lady, and let's meet our card sharks. Yeah. Hello, Gerrie.
Hi, Bill.
How you feeling?
I feel on top of the world.
I don't blame you. She is a new champion. She stepped up to the plate yesterday and picked up some cash and that brand new Jeep Wrangler over there. And that gives us a total of $15,109 cash and prize. Why don't you just tell the folks at home a little bit about yourself, please?
Well, I live in beautiful Fresno, California. I have 7 children. I operate a wedding service, and I specialize in doing unusual wedding ceremonies.
What's the most unusual wedding ceremony you've done?
2. One was on top of a Ferris wheel, and the other one was the entire wedding party and all of their formal attire was on roller skates.
Roller skates?
And I'm getting ready to do another one next week on roller skates.
Okay. Do you take this man to be your love? Go by you in a circle. All right. Let's meet our new challenger here. Let's say hello to Ray. Hello, Ray.
Hello.
Introduce yourself, please.
I'm Ray Vega. I just moved here from New York via Nashville, Tennessee, where I spent 2 years working on my craft. I'm a musician. I'm 25 years old. I'm single, and I'm ready to play.
You're ready to play. All right. I like a guy that knows what he wants to do. Good luck to both of you right now. Don't forget about our prize cards in the deck. And today we've got a trip to Puerto Vallarta. So you can get down to Mexico and get in the sun. Yeah. Have some fun. First game, first question. Susanna's already dealt out the cards. And it always goes to the champ. And this is our audience poll group. 10 Los Angeles County lifeguards. Nice group of guys. They're with us all week. Gerrie, before the show, we ask these 10 lifeguards. Some women look at lifeguards as hunks. Be honest. Do you ever think of yourself as a hunk? How many of these 10 lifeguards do think of themselves? I feel like I'm ordering meat at the butcher's. You know, I like a hunk of this, and let me have a hunk of that over there. How many of these 10 lifeguards do think of themselves as hunks?
Look at those egotistical grins. I don't think that they would admit it, even if they do. I feel like that's going to be a fairly low number, although that Don, that smile on his face, he's one that's going to say yes. I'm going to say that, 2.
You got your eye on Don, huh? I like that. Okay. She's going with 2. Ray, what do you think, higher or lower?
Well, I'll tell you, I was a lifeguard back in Texas, where I grew up, and I know I did very well. I never admit it, but I did very well. And I think, I agree with her, but I think the number's going to be a little higher.
I just like the way you threw in, I did very well.
Very well, yeah.
I'm asking if they're hunks. He's going, I was a lifeguard and I did very well. I did okay. Okay, he's going higher than 2. Yes. The actual number of these lifeguards who think of themselves as hunks is 1. Oh. It is 1. So it is not higher, it is lower. They don't go to the beach to meet girls and they're not hunks. This is interesting. Who is the one guy who thinks of
you know.
It's Harry?
Well, you see, we were all top swimmers in our day. And I think that's why we all think of ourselves as hunks. These guys just don't want to admit it.
So you're going to shoulder that burden yourself, aren't you, Harry? We're learning a lot about Harry. I don't know. Thank God you don't wear a hat, Harry. I don't think you can get through the door. But anyway, have a seat right now. Thank you very much.
His wife was more shocked than anybody.
It was his wife?
Yes.
You didn't hear it. Susanna just said his wife was more shocked than anybody when he answered that. Okay, here you are, Gerrie. Here is a card. Tell me what you want to do with an ace.
Lower
than an ace. Here's a 6.
Let's go higher. higher.
She says higher. Here's a three. Oh. She was indecisive. If you've watched the games now, or if you've been with us since yesterday, you know that this lady has some psychic abilities that are unnerving. Ray, you get a free shot.
Oh,
you
yeah.
must play from a 10.
I tell you what it's going to be. It's going to be lower.
Lower than a 10? Here's
$500. Yeah.
$500, one of our prize cards. And here comes Lacey racing out to place
Thank
it on Ray's side of the board right now. And we have a 10 again, and we'll
it's,
call.
It's going to be lower.
He says lower again.
Lower.
There's an 8.
I'm gonna play on. That's going to be a higher card.
Higher than an 8?
Yeah.
There's a 3. Both undone by threes. Wasn't it 2 threes that came up?
Yes.
Am I right?
That's
anyway.
A three.
Okay, we'll be back with our second question right after this break.
Can you
come back? Middle of our first game. Not a lot of damage done to the cards yet. Here's our next question, and this one goes to Ray.
Yes.
Ray, we surveyed 100 mothers, and we asked them, have you ever said to your child, do as I say, not as I do? How many mothers admitted they have used that familiar line on their child?
Oh, yes. I have a wonderful mother, and she has said it to me many, many times. So I think that number is going to be pretty high. I'm going to say about 68.
68?
Mothers, yes.
Gerrie, you're a mom of 7. You have some experience in this category.
Boy, and I can't lie, my daughter's in the audience. I think it seems to me that young mothers today feel like they're setting more of an example, or they're trying really hard to be honest. Not to say my mother wasn't honest, for God's sake. I think it's going to be lower than that.
You're going lower than that.
I think it's lower.
Lower. The actual number of mothers who have said, do as I say, not as I do, is 37. It is lower. It is lower. So, the voice of experience is heard from. Gerrie, you got an ace here.
Lower.
Lower. There's
Whoa.
A jack.
Lower.
Lower than a jack. Here's a 6.
Let's go higher.
Higher than a 6. Here's a king.
Let's go lower.
Game number 1 is in the balance, and there
Yay.
It is. Very good. Right across the board on the second question, and there it is. Game number 1 in the champ's pocket. If she wins the next one, she's off to the money cards again. And we know, of course, now that Ray, you've got to tie it up here.
Yeah, I'm ready.
You're ready to
oh,
do
yeah,
it?
Yeah, let's do it.
Because if he doesn't do it here, he goes to the land of parting gifts. He is gone. So here we go.
The island, as I may say.
Yeah, Suzanne is dealing out the cards for game number 2 right okay. now. And here is our question, and it goes to Gerrie. We surveyed 100 single women, and we asked them, would you accept an engagement ring from the man you loved if you knew it once belonged to his ex-wife? I just wanted to see if you liked the ring, honey. I'll get it off that hand in a moment. Don't worry about it. How many single women would accept the engagement ring anyway?
That's a terrible thought. It would be like haunted or something. No, I think that would... How many would accept the ring?
How many single women would accept the engagement ring?
A very low number. There's no way I would touch that ring. I'm going to say 11.
11. Ray?
I think it is going to be a low number. However, I'm going to have to say a little bit higher than 11.
A little bit higher. Yeah. Going with the odds here a little bit.
Sure.
He says low, 11's real low. I'm going a little higher.
Yeah.
The actual number of single women who would accept an engagement ring that belonged to their fiancé's ex-wife is 13. It is a little higher.
All right. All right.
A little higher.
Yeah.
Way to go, Ray. He's got to get to this board here and win this game. Let's take a look at the card. You can change it if you like. It's a 5.
No, I'm going to go higher. I'm going to go higher.
With it. It says higher than a 5. Here's a king.
Yes, I'm going to lower.
Lower than a king. Here's an 8.
Yeah. I'm going to go... Okay, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going lower.
You're going to go for
I'm going lower. Go
he says,
it.
He says, the crowd got him there, but he says,
I'm
forget it.
Lower.
I'm going lower than an 8. And there is Puerto Vallarta.
Oh, yeah.
That's a prize card.
Now can I see?
So, this goes up on his side of the board. And if you notice, Ray has got 2 prizes up there, $500 in cash
Whoa.
And the trip. Can't win them unless he wins the match. You have an 8.
I'm going to freeze.
You're going to freeze.
This time, sure.
I agree with that. I think you should, too. He's going to freeze right now. And we'll be right back and see if that strategy pays off right after this. I was going to say, you got a lot of stake there.
Cupid's arrow.
Welcome back. Here we are. Exciting game taking place right now. It is a must-win situation for Ray, our challenger. He just froze on an 8, and the strategy is, if he gets this next question right, he changes that 8 and hopefully goes on and ties this match up. Let's see what happens. Ray,
yes.
Educated guess.
Ooh, my favorite.
What's the fastest speed ever attained in outer space by any manned or unmanned space vehicle?
Oh, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to go with a high, 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 high number. That's going to be about 1,800 miles.
All right, you're going 1,800 miles per hour. 1,800 miles per hour.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, that's your answer? It is locked in stone. Gerrie, higher or lower?
Higher. I think I've heard of things that have gone over 2,000 at least. I'm going to go higher.
You're going higher than 1,800 miles per
hour? Yes.
The fastest speed ever attained by a space vehicle is, listen to this, 149,125 miles per hour. That is amazing.
Whoa.
That is amazing. Unbelievable. Gerrie, you are right. You go to the board. 149,000 miles per hour. Whew. That's astounding to me. Here you are, Gerrie. You got to.
Let's go lower it in the
kit. Lower. Here's a five.
Go higher.
Higher than a five. It is a seven.
She stays right there.
She stays right there. She's going to stop on that seven. Next question is for her. Again, we surveyed 100 second grade boys and we asked them, would you like to live your whole life without ever having to kiss a girl? How many second grade boys would like to go through life without kissing a girl?
Lots of them. They don't like girls. No, they don't like girls. I have an 8-year-old grandson and a 6-year-old grandson, and neither one of them likes girls, and they certainly wouldn't want to kiss a girl. Out of 100? 68.
68.
Ray? Well, I tell you, when I was in second grade, I won a kissing contest. So I know I like to kiss girls at that age, anyway.
Some people know their careers very early in life, right?
Yeah. 68. I think it's going to be a little bit higher.
A little bit higher than that.
68. Yeah,
going, I think with, these, going yeah. with the odd series. Sure. The actual number of second grade boys who would like to go through life without kissing a girl is 24.
Wow.
It is not yeah. higher, it is lower. Whoa. Gerrie, here it is.
I want to change that card.
She wants to change a seven. She now has an ace.
I want to go lower.
Lower. It is a love seat and sofa.
We knew you did.
Here is a love seat and sofa. The prize goes up on the board. If you win the match, you get the prize. Again, we've got an ace, and we're going lower. Here's an eight.
Let's freeze on the eight.
We're going to freeze on the
eight. Yeah, I'm going to freeze
on the eight. Even though she's got one game in her pocket, she can waste one here. She's a conservative player and stops right there. And let me remind everybody, especially Ray, this is real important to him, sudden death.
Okay.
This is our final question. Somebody must win the game on the next play of the cards. Control of the board's the whole key here, and you got it. Here we go. This is our audience poll group. Again, we have our 10 Los Angeles County lifeguards. All right, Ray, this is for you. Before the show, we asked the 10 lifeguards, have you worn a suit and tie within the last year? How many of these 10 lifeguards have worn a suit and tie within the last year?
Oh, God, I'll tell you. Look at them, they're all smiling. You know, some, I think that, you know, with weddings and all, they have to at least worn a suit once in the last year. I'm going to say that number is going to be about four.
Four?
Yeah.
What do you think, Gerrie?
I think with dating and weddings and other functions, it's going to be higher.
You're going higher than
four? I'm going higher than four.
All right. The actual number of these lifeguards who have worn a suit and tie within the last year is nine. Nine. It is higher.
All right.
So we not, nine of you have, so we kind of... Who's the guy who hasn't? Who is it? Coco!
Coco!
Coco! You
I don't even own one if I have.
I'll rent one
if I need one.
All right, good for you. Have a seat right now. Thank you, fellas. Here we go, Gerrie. You know what the situation
change
is.
Change the eight.
Well, it's sudden death. You can play or pass. What do you want to do?
I can change it, though.
Yeah, if you can change the card and play on, but if you make a mistake, Ray automatically wins the game. Or you can pass it over to Ray.
Let's have Ray play off what he's
You're
got.
You're going to let Ray play it out. She goes with the odds again. Conservative play. He's got two calls. Ray is forced to play from the
yes.
eight.
That number's going to be lower.
Lower than an eight.
Lower than the eight. Let's go.
This is sudden death.
Lower.
He'll either tie this up or leave us.
Lower.
Lower than an eight. It is an eight. That means Gerrie wins it. She puts you in the spot. Put you in the spot.
I did.
Thank you.
All right, Ray, I want to thank you so much for being here.
That was a lot of fun.
I wish it would have worked out for you a little better than it has, but we've got some nice gifts for you backstage.
Wonderful, wonderful.
Yeah, she's a terrific champ.
Really well.
Thank you, Ray.
Thank you.
So long now. Come on over here, Gerrie. Come on over here.
Oh, the buttons fell off my couch.
Oh, let's take a listen right now. Bob, tell her about her prize, please.
All right, it's Lazy Boy Signature 2 Sofa with Deluxe Inner Spring Mattress and Matching Love Seat. Available in many fabrics to suit almost any decor. You may enjoy elegance by day, comfort by night. Furnished by Lazy Boy. Congratulations.
All right, thank you very much, Bob. Well, Grandma of 70, you can always use a new couch and a new love seat, that's for sure. We'll be back with the money cards and the car right after this. Back. Here we are with Gerrie, our champion. She's back at the money cards right now, and of course she knows how to play them. And again, let me remind you folks at home, in addition to all the money she can win, we've added a joker to the deck. And any time that turns up in the money cards, she's going to have an opportunity to win that fabulous Jeep Wrangler right back there. And for winning the match, we will guarantee her a chance at that because we're going to give her an extra joker. And there it is right now. Susanna's holding it for her. Let's get started right now. Let us give Gerrie $200. All right, Gerrie, come on, make some money. You got $200 and an ace.
All of it lower.
All of it lower than an ace. There's a three. 400 on a three.
350 higher.
$350 higher than a three. It is a 10. $750 on a 10.
I'm going to change the card. Number two.
She could change one card per line. She changes this 10. It now becomes a nine. Think about this. $750 on a nine.
$100 higher.
Again, she always goes $100 higher than a nine. There is a joker. We told you about it just before. We'll give it to Susanna. Now she has two chances at the car. Very important card to turn over. Thank you, Lacey. We replace that card right now. You've got a nine. Let's recap the bet. You have $750. What do you want to do?
$100 higher.
Again, $100 higher than a nine. There is a four.
Okay.
$650. We're going to take you up to the second line and give you $400 more. You have $1,050. You're working off a four.
Let's go $400 higher.
400 higher? 400 higher than a four? It is a nine.
Let's change that card with number one.
Oh, come on. Let's get a good card up here. It's a seven. $1,450 on a seven.
Let's go $400 higher.
$400? Right in the middle. It can go either way here. 400 higher than a seven? It is a six.
Okay.
$1,050 on a six.
Okay, let's go 300 higher.
300 higher than a six? It is a six. No win, no loss, a push. You now have $1,050 and you're working off
a six.
Let's
change the card with a three.
All right. You realize, of course, now that you must wager at least half on this card. It is a four.
How much do I have?
You have $1,050. You must wager at least $525.
The expression, no guts, no glory, let's go all of it higher.
You're going for it. Way to go. All of it higher than a four. Hit it. You did it. Wonderful. Very nice job. That was a tough roll. Tough play of the cards. You had a lot of trouble there, and you ended up coming out with $2,100. So you did quite well, young lady, and you did turn over an extra joker. Here is Susanna with your jokers. I'm going to give them to you right now because if you listen very carefully, Bob Hilton will tell you all about this Jeep Wrangler.
It's the Wrangler. Continues the tradition that made a Jeep a legend. With room for four, the Wrangler offers personal control, comfort, and the flexibility to enjoy both on- and off-road driving from Jeep Corporation. Good luck, Gerrie.
Okay, there we go now, Gerrie. Right in front of you, you got two jokers. In front of you, a seven-numbered card. Behind one of them is the word car. Find it. Go get it. Four and seven. An even number, an odd number. Any particular reason for four? None. Just, I got to put them somewhere, and I put them there. All right, let's take a look. Is the word car behind number four? No, it is not. We go to lucky number seven. Now, I have to remind everybody that yesterday, if you were watching the show, this young lady walked up and picked up the car. So we're talking about 2 days in a row, two cards. The odds here are absolutely phenomenal that you're going to see car! her back right now. And it has just about calmed down here. Now, what did you say you were going to do now? You were going to what?
I said I'm going to get a bikini and I'm going to drive around and get this wonderful tan.
And you're douchey. Anyway, there is a rule here that when you win two cars, we have to say goodbye to you. And that is exactly what we're going to have to do with Gerrie. This is Gerrie's last day with us. However, I don't want you to weep uncontrollably because Gerrie is going home with $30,922 cash in prizes. Terrific. And you couldn't have gone to a nicer lady. We had a fun time with you here. My name is Bill Rafferty. We'll see y'all right here tomorrow on Card Show. Bye-bye. Something you can always use, a new couch and a new love seat. That's for sure. We'll be back with the money cards. And
I'm the master reptile.